morning. How are you?
I am fine. How are you?
I am also fine. What a coincidence. I was just thinking to meet you. I need your help in my project. I am doing research on comparative study of various religions. And these days, it is Islam. And I think you are the person who can guide me in this matter.
Sure, Ravi. This will be my pleasure to help you and make you understand my Islam and its culture. We are simple living people. Come on, let's move.
Where?
See the live example of our Islamic society.
अरे बहुत दिन हो गए हम बच्चों को कहीं घुमाने नहीं ले गए।
हाँ, इस संडे मेरा ऑफिस का कुछ काम नहीं है, हम बच्चों को घुमाने ले जाएंगे।
मम्मी, please help me in my maths homework. I am not able to do these sums.
Wait, I am coming.
Come here, बेटा, I will help you. Your mummy is busy in the kitchen.
Thank you, Papa. अरे आयान इस वोक अप अगेन।
You continue with your work. I will manage.
मैन इन द किचन, मर्द भी आपके यहाँ घर के कामों में मदद करते हैं।
लेट्स आस्क देम ओनली।
डियर ब्रदर, कैन वी टॉक टू यू?
यस, व्हाई नॉट?
डियर ब्रदर, डोंट यू थिंक दैट द वर्क यू आर डूइंग इन द किचन इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ योर वाइफ?
ओह माय डियर ब्रदर, हैजंट यू हर्ड द हदीस रिपोर्टेड बाय आयशा रज़ियल्लाहु अन्हा? Whenever someone asked her, what did Prophet ﷺ used to do in his free hours, she replied, he keeps himself busy in serving his family. One more hadith says, he even patched garments and saved. मैं तो अपनी नबी की सुन्नतों को फॉलो कर रहा था।
Oh, I see. Thank you so much.
Mummy, how are you feeling today? Have you taken the medicines regularly?
Yes, beta. Today I am feeling better. Just my legs are paining too. Still.
Assalamu alaikum, mummy. Assalamu alaikum, bhabhi.
Walaikum assalam.
Walaikum assalam.
What happened to you, mummy? Bhai, is everything okay?
Yes, beta, everything is okay. Just my legs are paining too much. Enough, children, you are tired.
No, mummy, serving you will lead me to the path of paradise. Why should we leave this opportunity? You have only taught me in Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Bani Israel, ayat 23, the Lord has decrees, do not worship except him, and to parents good treatment, whether one or both of them reach old age with you. Say, do not oof to them and do not repel them, but speak to them is a noble worship.
I am very happy that you are implementing the teaching of Quran Hadith in your life.
Oh, I got answer from son only.
वैसे भी उन्होंने सही ही कहा, कुरान और हदीस में भी कहा गया है कि अल्लाह के बाद हम पर सबसे ज़्यादा हमारे वालिदैन का हक है और उन्हें उफ भी कहने के लिए मना किया गया है।
From the wrong spelling, you don't know anything.
I know everything. This is right. You go and find in a dictionary.
Yes, we are right.
Okay, you are right.
Assalamualaikum.
Walaikum assalam, beta.
Mummy, mummy.
What happened, beta?
Arhan has brought a new color pen.
So what? He might need it. Aisha.
What happened, mummy?
Go and change. Come for lunch. Arhan, beta.
Yes.
Have you brought any color pen?
Yes.
How you brought it? I haven't given you any money.
I know, mummy. He had taken money from your purse. Even he didn't ask your permission.
Aisha, you just keep quiet.
But it is wrong, Arhan. How could you do this? You have taken money from my purse. This is not good behavior. You should ask me. I would have given you.
Arhan, what happened? Arhan, what happened?
See, Nazadi, Aisha always does it. She told mummy about the color pen. And mummy also shouted on me. I only brought a color pen because I need it for my drawing class.
I understand that you need it, beta. But how you brought it, it was wrong. You should have asked your mother first that I want money for the pen. She should surely give it to you. She always brought everything for you. The wrong thing was that you have brought a coloring pen without her permission and taking money without her permission. This is not correct. Okay, so now go and tell your mother sorry. This will never repeat again.
Dadi, mummy will forgive me?
Yes, beta.
Sorry, mummy, I will never repeat this again.
It's okay, beta, never repeat this again.
Oh, it was just a matter of 10 rupees. Let me talk to the grandfather. Excuse me, uncle, can we talk to you?
Yes, of course, why not?
Uncle, why didn't you speak? It was just 10 rupees. Mummy and Dadi both made the child cry.
I think you love kids, but the fact is we have learned from our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that your child has a right over you. So it is our responsibility to make him responsible and honest individual. Beta, humare nabi ne hame sikhaya hai ki tumhari aulaad ka tum par haq hai. Isliye humari zimmedari hai use ek imandar ummati banaye.
Thank you so much.
Assalamu alaikum, Abbu.
Walaikum assalam. How was your day?
Fine, Abbu.
How is your study going on?
It is going on.
In our time also, we used to tell the same answer to our parents.
Abbu, I think I want to talk to you about my career.
Let's sit and talk.
Abbu, I think I want to change my field. I do not want to continue in civil engineering, but I want to continue in computer engineering.
Have you thoughtfully taken this decision?
Yes, Abbu, but still I want your opinion for my further career.
I respect your opinion. Only choose career according to your hobby so that your work becomes your passion, not responsibility. And that always gives best result.
Yes, bhai, as my choice was to become a doctor, Abbu has also guided me in the same way. So now I am happy with my profession.
But beta, tell me one thing, what is the problem in civil engineering? There is always a way to solve the problem.
Abbu, the classes of civil engineering are too far and my time is all gone in transit only. So I am not able to focus on my studies properly and my progress is getting low day by day.
But beta, think about one thing, you are always free to opt what is better for you. But the matter is, what about the resources that we have spent since your 10th? The hard work of your mother has done for you, your efforts, your full night studies, your sacrifices and much more. Kya ye sab aise hi zaya jaane de? Aapko nahi lagta Allah Pak humse is bare mein sawal karenge?
Yes, Abbu, this thing never come in my mind. But I think if classes are nearby, so I can manage the things.
Okay, so tomorrow we'll go and find some coaching classes for you.
Let's go and search nearby institute on net for you.
to see a father respecting the child's opinion and guiding him in his path. Is there something about this also in your Islam?
Yes, Islam gives all attention to the need for showing respect to the children. The Prophet of Islam has said that, respect your children and give them good training so that Allah rewards you.
अरे रहने दीजिए, कमर जक जाएगी।
अरे भाई मुझे कुछ नहीं होगा, अभी तो मैं फिट हूँ।
अरे यार पहले वाले चैंपियन नहीं रहे, उम्र का तो लिहाज करें।
चलो चलो दादा, मैं तुमको कराटे सिखाता हूँ।
हाँ हाँ चलो बेटा। अरे ये देखिए, उम्र बचपन की और दिल बचपन का।
अरे देखो बेटा मैं कितना अच्छा कर रहा हूँ।
रुको रुको दादा, मुझे लग रही है,
इसलिए तो मैं जाती नहीं स्कूल। ये सब होता है सैटरडे को, मैं कल स्कूल नहीं जाऊंगी। मम्मी मैं कल स्कूल नहीं जाऊंगी।
क्यों, कल स्कूल की छुट्टी है?
नहीं मम्मी।
तो फिर क्यों नहीं जाओगी?
कल कराटे है।
तो इसके लिए तुम स्कूल मिस कर दोगी?
मैं थक जाती हूँ।
ऐसे कैसे थक जाती हो?
जाने दो बहू, अगर उसका मन नहीं है तो जिद क्यों कर रही हो? हाँ मेरा बच्चा थक जाता है।
अरे बेटा कैसी बातें कर रही हो, फिजिकल फिटनेस तो कितनी ज़रूरी होती है। तुम्हें पता है आप सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के ज़माने में औरतें इतनी फिट हुआ करती थी कि मर्दों को टक्कर दे देती थी। और जंगे उहद में हज़रत उम्मे अम्मारा रज़ी अल्लाहु अन्हा ने आप सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम का डिफेंड किया। और एक औरत जिनका नाम उम्मे हकीम बिन्त हारिस है, उनका वाक्या है कि वो फिजिकली इतनी फिट थी कि जंग में एक डंडे से अपना डिफेंस किया और 7 फौजियों को मार गिराया। तो फिजिकल फिटनेस की इम्पोर्टेंस को समझो। और तुम्हें तो अभी ये सुनहरा मौका मिला है कि तुम आसानी के साथ कराटे सीख सकती हो, तो अब से तुम्हें एक भी क्लास मिस नहीं करनी चाहिए।
जी दादाजी, अब से मैं एक भी क्लास मिस नहीं करूंगी और अपनी सेल्फ डिफेंस की हर टेक्निक्स को सीखूंगी।
अरे तुम्हारी दादी को भी स्कूल जाकर सिखा लाया करो।
हमारी स्कूल में इतने बड़े को नहीं सिखा।
अरे हाँ, आज के दौर में फिजिकल फिटनेस बहुत ज़रूरी है।
हाँ भाई बिल्कुल सही कहा।
Salaam, Khala.
Wonderful to see you. Sit, Didi.
What a nice surprise.
I thought I will have to wait till Sunday to meet you.
Something special that made you wait for me?
No, I just want to play with Ariba. I was missing her.
Okay, but I have come here with a special reason.
Oh, I know. You are going on a trip next month, so you need my jewelry.
That's so childish. Dear, I have come here for your batter.
And what is that batter?
See, Abbu has sent me 5 marriage profile. He wants you to think and select one of it for you, so that we can decide further procedure.
How would I know who is perfect for me?
See, if you will find any perfection, I am telling you, nobody is perfect. We can always choose for the better one. If you need, we can help you.
Obviously. Have I taken any decision without your help?
See, Abbu has come.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, Abbu. Abbu, sit down. Abbu, we will discuss with her.
Yes, bachcha, what's going on?
Abbu, we were discussed about her future, would be.
So has she decided or selected anyone, or she has her own choice?
Abbu, she need our help.
We are always ready to help her in her decision, but the last decision will be only hers.
How come a father can think best about his daughter? The girl is not that mature to take such a sensible decision.
Let's come and ask her father only. Brother, can we please talk with you?
Yes, of course.
Dear brother, I think you are the best person to select correct spouse for your daughter.
Oh my dear brother, let me tell you one of the interpretation of hadith that is reported by Abu Hurairah radhiyallahu anhu. That is, nikah is not permissible in Islam without the girl's permission.
Thank you.
क्या आपको ये निकाह कबूल है?
कबूल है.
आपको एक कबूल है?
कबूल है.
आपको 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 कबूल है?
कबूल है.
कैसी शादी है? ना बैंड बाजा, ना कोई दावत और ना ही बराती.
चलो मौलाना साहब से ही पूछ लेते हैं.
अरे मौलाना साहब, ये कैसी फीकी फीकी शादी करवा दी आपने? खाने का भी इंतजाम ना था.
अरे मियां, आप सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम को ऐसे ही निकाह पसंद था. अबू दाऊद हदीस मफून है, निकाह वही अच्छा है जिसमें कम से कम खर्च हो. आपको दावत ही खानी है ना, कल आ जाना. कल वलीमा है जो माना नबी सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम की सुन्नत है.
अरे ज़बरदस्त, आजकल शादी के खर्च बढ़ जाने की वजह से लोगों को कर्ज लेना पड़ता है, लोन लेनी पड़ती है और फिर पूरी जिंदगी किस्तों को पूरा करने में गुजर जाती है. वेरी नाइस, सिंपल लिविंग, हाई थिंकिंग.
सही कहा आपने.